Good morning. My name is Nath Bedi. Welcome to Chitkara. Today we are going to talk about aperitifs. When we talk about aperitifs, we are talking about their introduction, their history, various types of aperitifs, their production, and a few famous brand names. So if you talk about the introduction to aperitifs happen to be an alcoholic beverage which is served before a meal in order to stimulate the appetite, and that is why they are rather dry in taste as compared to sweet. Common choices are vermouth, champagne, pastis, gin, raki, fino, amontillado, and other types of dry sherry. An aperitif can also be an hors d'oeuvre or an amuse-bouche. So, if you talk about pastis, these are actually made from France and are based on anise. Then raki happens to be made in Albania, Turkey, Greece and the Balkan countries, served with meze or seafood, and it is also aniseed flavored. Then gin is made from juniper berries. Vermouth is made in your Italy, which happens to be fortified wines with botanicals. Botanicals happen to be your herbs and various spices. Then we have fino, which happens to be a dry sherry from Spain. Then we have champagne, which happens to be a sparkling wine, which is your made in the Champagne district of France. Then we have your sherry, which happens to be a fortified wine made from white grapes in Spain, Andalusia. Then we have Amontillado, which happens to be a dark sherry, which is matured. Then, as I mentioned, a amuse-bouche, this happens to be single bite-sized hors d'oeuvres, which are served free or according to the choice of the chef. Then, fortified wines are basically those wines in which brandy is added to increase the alcohol content. So, moving forward, the history. Aperitif happens to be a French word which was derived from a Latin word apere, which means to open. So these are those dishes which help in opening the appetite or opening the meal. There is no formal consensus as to when the aperitifs came into origin. They say that it goes back to ancient Egypt. That is why I have put up this photograph as well. In Europe and in the USA, it is said to have come into existence in the early 1900s. Now the various types of aperitifs that we have: vermouth, which happens to be a fortified wine which is made in Italy and it has botanicals. Then bitters, these are actually flavored with, these are also an alcoholic preparation which are flavored from botanicals, which are bitter in taste, sour in taste, or they might be bittersweet in flavor. Then we have fortified wines, which are your infusion in which the brandy is added in order to increase the alcohol content. Port, sherry, madeira, marsala are a few examples of fortified wines. Then if you talk about the production of various aperitifs, these are a few brands that we have. Pernod, which is made from star anise and herbs. Anise happens to be your sauce. Then Souze, from the extraction of gelatin steeped in wine. Then Pinot de Crances happens to be made with grape brandy adding grape brandy to unfermented grape juice. Then Cousin happens to be your herbs and plants infused in purified spirit, and essence of anise is added. Here in this photograph you can see a few herbs and the various spices which are used in the production of these particular beverages. Then we talk about various styles. We have Campari, we have Absinthe, we have Dubonnet, Vermouth, Pernod, Ricard, Pinot de Crances, Souze, Sherry, Strega, Cezano, and Ozu. These are a few basic brands that we have for aperitifs. Then the countries in which aperitifs are famous are your France, your Greece, Italy, Spain, United Kingdom, United States, and Germany. And here you can see the various cocktails which are made in fancy glasses with the help of these aperitifs. Aperitifs are also made to make very famous standard cocktail recipes, which are also called as signature cocktails. Then if you talk about the service, how do we serve these particular drinks? The best of others are 16-24% alcohol content or 32-48% proof. They are often wine derivatives or they are fortified, although some like the popular Campari are more like a wine. Then aperitifs can be served in a wide variety of ways, straight with ice, with water or with mixers. That depends on what kind of a preference the guest wants to take this particular aperitif with. Then this happens to be a basic aperitif menu which is there in a hotel in Italy. And here you can see the various bottles, the brands which are there in that particular hotel as such. Then talk about bitters. Bitters happen to be an aperitif which is made with the preparation of herbs and citrus fruits dissolved in alcohol or glycerin with a bitter or bittersweet flavor. Bitters were used as medicines in earlier times, but these days they are used as flavoring agents in cocktails or as a digestive with an alcohol content of almost 45%. Then bitter brands, with the famous brands for bitters. Angostura Bitter, which happens to be from Trinidad and Tobago. This is a very famous bitter brand. Arcano, which happens to be from Chile. Averna from Italy. Bicirovka from Czech Republic. Birrenberg from Netherlands. Campari from Italy. Martini, again from Italy. Jägermeister, which you can see the green bottle, which is from Germany. And Underberg, which is also from Germany. Now, a famous few aperitif cocktails which are there in the market, and they are like Adonis, the Americano, Campari cocktail, Gimlet, Gin and It, Kir Royale, Martini, Negroni, Rob Roy, Affinity, Park Avenue. And here you can also see the various cocktail glasses and the various cocktails which are made with these aperitifs. So I hope you liked my video. Thank you so much. And in the next video, we'll be talking about liquors moving forward. Please make sure to type your questions in the comment box and do like and subscribe my videos. Thank you so much.